when you're fishing for snook on the East Coast, what you want to do is gear up, make sure that you've got your strong gear, because they're going to run and jump and do everything they can to break your leader. What we are using today was a Daiwa Coastal rod, extra strong, Power Bro 30 pound braid, Yuzuri 50 pound fluorocarbon leader, and a Gamakatsu 5-0 live bait hook. We were using live thread fins, hooking them through the nose, but not the eyes, and then just freelining them over toward, throwing them towards the beach and freelining them back behind the boat. Snook, like we just saw the 40 pounder that Paul just caught.
42.
All right, but yeah, snook like we just saw are the reason that the Snook Foundation exists, to be honest with you. I mean, our whole point is to help restore and conserve as much inshore habitat as possible. And without habitat, you know, we lose our chance of fish like that. Habitat's quickly disappearing, and as we've seen over the last 20, 25 years, snook like that are quickly disappearing. Mike Redling, Board of Directors for the Snook and Gamefish Foundation.
Paul Mickley here from Navionics. Today we're out using Navionics' new feature called sonar charts. What sonar charts does, it allows you to record sonar, upload it to our website, and within a week, roughly, you now get 1 foot contours for everywhere you and every other boater recorded sonar that day. So it's an entire community effort of potentially thousands of boats that can do changes all the time. Here is a great example. Here's the Saint Lucie Inlet. Now the Saint Lucie just recently got dredged, so you can see there's no data here. But we actually go ahead and put on the sonar chart layer. You can now see all the brand new 1 foot contours that are now here after the dredging. And this actually was done by myself about 3 weeks ago. Just did a lazy ass pattern, and now you've got all this new data to see exactly where you want to fish. And that's Navionics Sonar Charts, brand new feature on Navionics.